The biggest hacks of 2022, coming up now on ThreatWire. Greetings, I am Shannon Morse, and this is ThreatWire for December 20th, 2022. This is your summary of the threats to our security, privacy, and internet freedom. Today, we are wrapping up the year with the biggest five hacks of 2022. Now, these were chosen based not necessarily on data size of a leak, but also on financial or privacy impact as well. So let's go ahead and start with number five. The DeFi platform Wormhole was attacked way back in February. An attacker stole about $325 million worth of cryptocurrency. It happened due to an update that occurred on the project's GitHub repository, in which a known vulnerability update had not yet been applied to production code, but it was uploaded to the GitHub account. Now, since it was not applied, the attacker was able to exploit this vulnerability and forge a valid signature for a transaction on Wormhole, which allowed them to freely mint Ethereum on the Solana blockchain valued at $325 million. The attack happened on the 2nd, and Wormhole posted about it on Twitter on the same day. They took their network offline for a short outage, saying that it was down for maintenance. Wormhole offered the attacker a $10 million bounty to return the funds. Now, this caused a 10% drop in the value of Solana cryptocurrency, and Wormhole added more Ethereum to replace the collateral funds one-to-one. At the time, this was the second largest DeFi hack ever, and the biggest one to hit in 2022. Now, while not the biggest hack in scope, this one did affect highly vulnerable people, and as such, that puts it on my list. The International Committee of the Red Cross announced the data for more than 515,000 people, highly vulnerable people, was compromised in an attack which likely stemmed from state-sponsored attackers. Now, technically, the initial intrusion began in late 2021, but it was not disclosed or discovered until 2022, when they found further information about the data breach. The attackers actually spent about 70 days with access to the servers before they were discovered. Now, this breach happened due to a known but unpatched highly critical vulnerability in the single sign-on tool called Zoho, which was used by the organization. Attackers were able to gain a foothold on their servers, where web shells and exploitation activities happened, allowing them to steal admin creds and exfiltrate data. People affected were in the Restoring Family Links program, which reconnects missing people and children to their families after being separated due to war or violence. Data like names, locations, and more were impacted. Number three gets a place on this list because it affected nearly 1 in 3 Australians and put them at risk of major identity theft and financial issues like fraud. In September, Australia's second largest mobile operator, Optus, disclosed the security breach, saying that an attacker might have had access to customer data. That included names, dates of birth, phone numbers, physical and email addresses, driver licenses, and passport numbers. In total, this affected 11 million customers of the telecommunications giant. According to the attacker, they used an unsecured API endpoint to steal the data. They then posted a small sample of the data on a hacking forum, demanding a $1 million USD ransom. Now, Optus did not reply to that ransom. About 10,000 customers had their data leaked on the forum for free, which led to many customers getting phishing and ransom messages sent to them. The Australian Federal Police launched an operation to identify the malicious actor, and shortly after, a user on the forum, who probably was the one that leaked it, stated that they would not be selling any of the data due to the law enforcement activity and a target on their back. But even with this change, Optus still had nearly 2.1 million customers affected in the leak, with each of those people having at least one forum identification number exposed. Another 7.7 million customers had no valid or current ID numbers exposed, but the leak did include email addresses, phone numbers, and dates of birth. Number two is the Los Angeles Unified School District, the second largest school district in the USA, who suffered a ransomware attack earlier this year in the fall. The Russian-speaking Vice Society hacking group claimed responsibility, and they hit the LAUSD email, computer systems, and apps with an attack. The group demanded a ransom, but district officials refused to pay it, saying the funds should go to students and education. Now, when their extortion was ignored, the group published stolen data amounting to over 500 gigs worth, including personally identifiable information like passports, social security numbers and tax forms, contracts and legal documents, financial data, health and COVID testing data, conviction reports, and psychological assessments for students. So in total, this was almost 300,000 files of information. LAUSD has more than 1,000 schools and 600,000 students in the district. So this affected a huge amount of young people and minors. Biggest of shout outs to my Hush Puppy perk level patrons today and every day for sharing their fur baby photos and for the support. My YouTube channel is youtube.com/Shannon Morse for everything from tech reviews to security tutorials. If you are traveling for the holidays, make sure to check out my newest video all about privacy pro tips when you travel. And also don't forget to like and subscribe to Hack 5 as well. Let's go ahead and finish out today's episode with the biggest hack of the year. And this one is the Lapsus hacks. Now, I lumped all of these together because they were all blamed on the same group, Lapsus. In 2022 alone, this hacking group attacked Microsoft, Cisco, Samsung, Nvidia, Okta, Rockstar Games, purportedly, and Uber, each time using similar techniques to gain access to systems. So according to Uber, for example, the attackers gained access via a compromised device owned by a contractor who had their corporate account credentials stolen and used. The attackers used repeated attempts to log into the contractor's Uber account, which eventually gave the contractor 2FA code notification fatigue, so they finally just accepted one of the 2FA requests. Even though the impact of this attack was minimal, the malicious actor did not change any code, but they instead just trolled employees on Slack, it was still a major issue. Now, unlike the Uber hack, Microsoft was also hit by the same group, but in their case, Bing, Bing Maps, and Cortana data was all stolen and partially uploaded as a torrent file. The group also leaked source code from Samsung and Nvidia. Now in December, Uber again was hacked. And this happened right at time of recording because yes, I am pre-recording this video before I travel for the holidays. Now these attacks prove that MFA is not a silver bullet for security, and MFA fatigue from notification prompt bombing is absolutely a thing used in attacks, especially this year. Offering employees phishing-resistant methods like hardware keys or pass keys for security can be so much more efficient and so much more secure. I wanted to say a huge thank you to all of my Alliance Patreon supporters this year, every year, and to everyone who subscribed and watched the show. Thank you so very much for your support. I will be back after the new year with all the security and privacy news after CES. I'm Shannon Morse. Happy holidays. I will see you on the internet.